After having climbed several peaks recently over 3000 meters, it was time to tackle one over 4000. I found a place in Switzerland where there are two such peaks, which are not too difficult to climb. These are Lagginhorn and Weissmies. To reach the starting point in the municipality of Sassgrund in the canton of Valle, you have to go through the Lotzenburg tunnel, but it's not a tunnel like any other. You have to put your car on the train. I left home quite late. I hadn't visited the destination before, so I had no idea how long it would take to get to Sassgrund. In fact, the rail network in Switzerland is very efficient. The shuttle trains depart every 20 or 30 minutes. Going through the Lotzenburg tunnel is quite quick, around 15 minutes, but costs 29 euros one way. The length of this tunnel is 14.5 kilometers. Finally, I get to the cable car parking in Sassgrund just before 6 pm. I check my backpack, turn on the GPS and start my hike. Normally I have to follow the route I downloaded from the internet, but based on the signpost there, I have to start my trek in the opposite direction. The valley is very steep, which makes it impossible to see Lagginhorn and the pass to take. The well-marked and easy route passes through a small, not very dense, but very well-maintained forest, as is always the case in Switzerland. I arrive at the more open and flatter area. Finally, I see the two peaks. They seem to be very close, too close. I have doubts. I'm used to walking for hours before reaching the top. In Switzerland, we can see things that you will never see elsewhere. Like here, they water the side of the mountain. It's incredible. The weather is exceptional. Bright sun, no wind, and it's hot. Fortunately, I didn't take my drone and its batteries. The weight of my backpack is less, which allows me to move forward without sweating too much. I have mixed feelings about this place. Indeed, there are ski lifts. I find they disturb the beauty of the landscape, but well, the local economy has to turn. If there were only people like me, who sleep and eat in their tent, then the restaurants and hotels wouldn't be able to survive. I move closer to Weissmies hut, the place where climbers usually spend the night before attacking the summit. A water outlet, certainly for making electricity. It's interesting to see how water is separated from pebbles. They use like a sieve. As often I don't know where I'm going to sleep. When crossing a small stream with difficulty, I run into an already prepared pit for my tent. As you can see close by is a quite noisy waterfall. This will stop me from sleeping well and disturb my plans. I've just pitched my tent and I'm ready to cook my small dehydrated meal and then retire to my sleeping bag. But before I need to get some water to cook, no need to melt the snow this time, the waterfall is there. No sunset tonight, the mountains are hiding the sun. I don't know what time I should be leaving in the morning, so as soon as the first climber passed by my tent, I decided to make a coffee, pack my stuff, and set off to conquer the Lagginhorn. Going to fetch water, I tripped and fell. I damaged my knee, the palm of one hand, and I hurt my ribs badly. The pain was bearable, so I decided to continue. Although I'm solo, I cannot say that I'm alone. Indeed, there are many other climbers. Their presence brings more courage and simplifies the advance. You just need to follow the lights of their headlamps. The terrain becomes rocky, and now you can see the glacier to cross. I hope the passage is easy because I didn't take crampons with me. The sun is rising. I've just overtaken the first mountain lovers. The glacier was easy to cross. No big crevasses, the snow cover was quite thin and provided good grip. I find myself once again in the rocks. The terrain becomes steeper but doesn't cause any technical difficulties. On the other side of the valley you can see more 4000 meters peaks, such as Taschhorn, 4491 meters, or Dom, 4545 meters. When it was dark, one could see the light of headlamps of climbers on their way up. We can now see the Weissmies summit, which I plan to conquer tomorrow, but frankly my motivation was marred by the sleepless night. I've just passed a group of young Germans. It's their first 4,000 meter peak. As I approach the summit, a very cold wind begins to blow. I have to put on my windbreaker. The summit is within reach. I begin to feel this growing excitement. Voila, I'm here at the top. I like to experience this moment alone, or only with my partner Karen. Here, unfortunately for me, this time I'm not alone. Moreover, the summit is quite narrow, not possible to put a tent or to sleep. But hey, it's done. As always, the view is magical, but the cold wind is blowing quite hard. The ridge between Weissmies and Lagginhorn is magnificent. I need to come back and do it someday. I feel great and happy to have climbed this summit. I have no more pressure to achieve the second summit. Time to go down. On the way down, about 100 meters from the top, I met a couple. The girl has frozen fingers. They decided to turn back. How disappointing for them. In the mountains you should always have warm clothes with you. The weather can change very, very quickly. Arriving at the bivouac, I decide to go back to my car. Weissmies is for next time. Thank you for watching and see you soon.